कैपिटलिज्म सोशलिज्म इन रशिया। द रशियन सोशलिस्ट डेमोक्रेटिक वर्कर पार्टी SDWP वॉज फाउंडेड इन 1898 बाई सोशलिस्ट हु रेस्पेक्टेड मार्क्स आइडिया और हु आर द फॉलोअर ऑफ कार्ल मार्क्स। प्रीवियस वीडियो वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द कार्ल मार्क्स। सम रशियन सोशलिस्ट फेल दैट पीसेंट वर नेचुरल सोशलिस्ट एंड दे वुड बी द मेन फोर्स ऑफ रेवोल्यूशन एंड रशिया कुड बिकम सोशलिस्ट मोर क्विकली देन अदर कंट्रीज। दे फॉर्म द सोशलिस्ट रेवोल्यूशनरी पार्टी इन 19th century. This party struggled for peasants' rights. Social Democrats disagreed with the social revolutionary about peasant. That clear? The Social Democrat Worker Party was disagreed with the socialist revolutionary party which is formed by the peasant of the Russian, and all you know, mostly 85% population of Russia were peasant. In 1903, the party was divided into two groups. That means which party? The Social Democratic Party. One known as Mensheviks and second is Bolsheviks. Bolsheviks were the majority group of the workers of Russia, who under the leadership of Lenin believed in the revolutionary method for bringing about the change in the society and the country. Mensheviks, this group was in minority and hence its members were known as Mensheviks. In Russia, Mensheviks means minority and Bolsheviks means majority. It is the Russian language. So all are clear? Bolsheviks means majority and Mensheviks means minority. The Mensheviks favored parties existing the France and Germany which took part in election to the legislatures of their countries. But this party failed to achieve anything because the Tsar of Russia, all you know, the Tsar Nicholas II, that means the king of Russia, did not believe in parliamentary method. He believed in divine power. So all are clear ki the Mensheviks was favor of the elected legislature, but the Tsar of the Russia was not there. So how can it possible to, without agreement of king, any parliamentary should be carried on? Russia was an autocracy and was ruled by Tsar. All you know, the Tsar Nicholas II. The Tsar, specially Nicholas II, was the self-willed, corrupt, oppressive ruler. We are also compared in the first video with the French Revolution. That means the King Louis XVI. Both of them are near about to the same nature. He ignored public welfare, as a result of which the condition of the peasant and worker become very deplorable. The worker and peasant both were divided. Peasant frequently refused to pay rent, even the murder the landlords. Being influenced by the democratic experiment, done by the Western European country that Russia also demand for a responsible government, but all their demand were turned out. Consequently, even the moderate reform began to talk of revolution. In the year 1904 was a bad year for the worker. Price of essential goods rose so high, wages declined 20%, the membership of the worker association rose dramatically because all are want to change the revolution. And the strike in the industrial area, that means the factory worker strike continuously against the exploitation of the worker, the wages, the working hour, the sanitation problem, the problem of the living area, all the things. Over 1,10,000 worker in St. Petersburg, all you know, the St. Petersburg, one of the most important industrial area, the two most important industrial area among the, one is Petersburg, went up the strike demanding a reduction in the working day to 8 hours and increase a wage and improvement the working condition of the workers. So all you are clear, whatever the Russian Revolution Party raised their voice in favor a parliamentary government where the king was just opposite. They want to be the self divine rights. So these are the opposite condition factor which lead the Russian Revolution.